Good day everyone, my name is Ruslan and welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we have another short and easy or simple video regarding important concepts and points and interview questions for site engineers. So we have a total of 11 points that we would be talking about. At number one, it says the formula to calculate the weight of steel bars. So for example, if you're a site engineer and you have to order steel and so how are you going to order it? Well, you know, steel is usually ordered in tons or in kgs, and in order to find the weight of steel bars per ton or per running meter, the formula we have is d squared divided by 162.2. So this was this would give us the weight in kgs for every meter, right? So kgs for every meter. And at number two, it says that formula to calculate the weight of steel bars, and this is the same formula d squared, but it's divided by 533. So this is in kgs per feet. So this is the two formulas we have to calculate the weight of steel bars. And what is the size of concrete testing cubes, which we usually use for our compressive strength test? So the size is 150 mm by 150 mm by 150 mm. And you can even see it on the pictures that I have. So these are the compressive strength cubes, and it's filled in I believe it's filled in three layers, right? So this is another important point. And you know, every layer has to be hammered 25 times, right? So hammer every layer 25 times and fill it in three layers. That's a very important point for site engineers. And at number four, it says that the concrete cube is filled in three layers, which I previously said, and remember to hammer every layer 25 times by rebar, so that you know there are no pores left or there's no holes inside, or and there are no air particles left within the concrete. So at number five, it says that the minimum thickness of shear wall is 150 mm, and you know, we have a diagram on the top left side, which denotes all the columns and the slabs and the beams and the RC wall, the reinforced concrete wall, and the foundation is, and the shear wall is usually, it's in the middle, it's somewhere in the middle for stability and strength and for proper, you could say, symmetry, right? So the maximum thickness of shear walls is 400 mm and the minimum is 150 mm. So remember these two very important points for structural engineers. And at number seven, it says that the slump cone is filled in four layers. Slump test is the most, you know, widely used test to find the workability of concrete. It's always done on site. So when concrete arrives on site, the first thing you do is you check the temperature. It shouldn't be more than 32.5 degrees, and then you do the slump test, and then you do the compressive strength test. So the slump cone should be filled in four layers, and remember to hammer every layer 20 to 25 times so that there are no pores or no air particles left. And number eight, it says that the minimum recommended thickness of DPC is 2.5 centimeters. DPC is the moisture control layer, which we have above the plinth level, and it stands for damp proof cement. It's cement mixed with waterproofing admixtures or materials. At number nine, the minimum percent of steel in columns is usually recommended to 0.08%, and the maximum percent of steel is 6%, right? So 6 and 0.08. At number 11, it says that the density of water is 1000 kgs per meter cube. So for example, if you want to find out the quantity of water in every batch of prepared concrete, so we would have to use the density of water. So the density is 1000 kgs per meter cube. So this was a simple and a short video, and we talked about 11 extremely important points which every site engineer must be familiar with. And I hope you guys learned something from this video, and we have many more short videos coming by, so make sure to subscribe to this channel and make sure you learn something from it. That's the most important part. So thank you for watching.